process of enriching flour begins with a grain seed. The seed consists of three parts: the bran, the germ, and the endosperm. Now, the bran is the outermost layer of the seed, and it's high in fiber, protein, and vitamin B. The germ is the embryo of the seed, and it's very high in protein. It's also high in fiber and vitamin B as well. The germ has a fat content of about 10%, so it can reduce shelf life. Ding, ding, ding. Key phrase, shelf life. You know where we're going here. The endosperm is the largest portion of the seed, and it's high in carbohydrates, and it does have some protein as well. Now we're going to look at the macronutrients and fiber content in each of these three. These numbers are based on 100 grams of each. Take note of the protein and the fiber content in the bran and germ. They provide some really good health benefits. Now that we've looked at the seed as a whole, it's time to get to the processing part. And what's the first rule of food processing? You guessed it. Take out the healthiest parts. So the bran and the germ are removed, and all that's left is the endosperm. Nice. And the question is, why? Well, manufacturers do this for improved texture, appearance, and of course, longer shelf life. Once the endosperm is isolated, it's ground into flour, and five of the nutrients are added back in. Take a bunch of nutrients out, add some back in. Makes the whole process sound so natural and delicious, doesn't it? Oh, and by the way, the fiber and the protein that were lost from removing the bran and the germ, they're not replaced. Bottom line, enriched flour is not the healthiest choice. 100% whole grain, whole wheat, flour, or bread are going to give you the most nutritional value. And that, it be the truth.